can't believe in love. Have you ever been in love before?
Yeah. Yeah. You know, it sucks. It's a dope place.
I know, man. It's rough. Yeah. It has its ups and downs.
It definitely does, man. But, yeah, you know, when that happens, it's going to be tight.
How do you get over like a hard breakup?
Shit, turn your swag all the way up.
Crying and then you gain hella weight or like doing things that's not good for you.
Yeah.
Like, can you
make it about yourself. You know what?
Fuck you then. Yeah, I'm gonna get mine. Jill, what's your DM game like? Do you play that shit?
Oh, outgoing?
All the things.
Okay, outgoing, I do it, you know. You do a picture or something that's in like Instagram.
Yeah.
A picture that's not pretentious or not like that. Some shit is even funny.
Yeah. I still love that.
Yeah, I did.
It's like a meme, bro.
Ontario was popping out with some little picture of Terry.
Yeah. They're like, ooh,
Terry. So, and just, you know, I say, what's up? You know, if you show up, I'll help with you.
Do you think, does it normally end up being pretty easy? Yeah. I wanted to ask, have you noticed a difference, like, the more and more you're getting on? Like, what's it like trying to date or trying to hook up with girls or whatever? Have bitches just be throwing themselves?
Yeah. It's crazy, but it's kind of, you know, people reveal themselves quicker that way, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, that's exactly what Pat said, too. He was like, the crazier ones, like, show the craziest.
Yeah, okay.
But,
exactly.
Yes.
So, you can't, you know, I'm normally, I'll be low key, man.
Yeah.
I'll be low key.
Have you ever had any, like, weird stalker fan girls or anything?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, God.
Mm-hmm.
And how do you deal with that? What do they do?
Shit, man. Like, constant DMs, and then you block that account, you know, it's a different, like, account.
What? Of the same person?
Yeah.
Oh, my.
Yes.
God. And you're like, do you have anything better? Get a hobby, bro. Besides riding my dick.
Come on, get another hobby.
What do you think about the double standard for, as far as like guys versus girls hooking up? Like it's chill for dudes. Like dudes be rapping or singing or whatever about fucking a slew of bitches.
And then
if a girl's like, I fucked every dude in LA, then they're like, oh god, that pussy cut up. And I was like, damn, you probably got in there.
Yeah, fucking, it's weak, but you know, I don't care about the past.
Yeah.
You know, as long as you're handling y'all stuff appropriately.
Yeah.
Like, the past don't matter, you feel me? So,
I agree. Yeah. What are you gonna do? Rehash every person
right.
You've ever
been with? Like, you can't do that. Like, you either gonna do it or you ain't. Like,
yeah.
You know?
It's like, if you're gonna judge me on that, good luck, man.
Good luck.
Do you think that as a society we are progressing though and just becoming more sexually free or open or understanding? I mean, especially like the whole trans revolution and like gay marriage finally think of. Thank you, base God.
Yeah, for sure. Shout out to that guy. Yeah, I do. I think we get there. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Slowly but surely. A couple more generations gotta die out.
Yeah, right.
And, you know what I'm saying?
I know. Those fucking old ratchety ass. Stop it, man.
Yeah.
This is not 1940, bro.
Exactly.
How do you get good at being good in bed?
So before, I always been like a little.
How did you lose your virginity, first off?
Shit. All right, so I had a basketball game. I was in the ninth grade. I had a basketball game, and the chick picked me up. Her mom picked me up, and then like, man, this shit took me to that crib. And then her little brother had like some Boy Scout thing, so the family went to that and left.
Left at the
I was like,
you're like, today is a good day. I'm on a basketball game. I hit it for the first time.
I was like, I came to school like, you know, it was awesome.
You're like,
she was awesome. Super awesome.
Hell yeah. Shout out. Young angels, blessing. I wish I've never taken anyone's virginity, but I think it's too late in the game.
It's too late.
And then, yeah, how do you get into bed? Did you watch porn? You just practice? Did you get tips from older dudes in the game who you looked up to?
I always, like, once I started, like, really messing with girls, I was eating pussy before I was having sex. You know what I'm saying?
That's good.
So, I knew,
good quality to attain.
I knew what would trigger what, you know, just from that. And it's like, okay, all this is like a combination game.
Yeah.
It's practice, study, you know what I'm saying? It's like a athlete.
Yeah, yeah,
you
gotta
practice, you gotta study the game, you know what I mean? And then.
Learn your moves.
Learn your moves. You're like, okay. Then,
go with it.
Then you got them creating new Instagram accounts.
Comedy. What makes a girl waifu material?
I would say just gorgeous. You know what I'm saying?
Damn. Real.
Real, I would say.
Yeah.
You know? Because like I said, it don't matter about your past, because you probably want to fuck with some shit you heard about my past or whatever. You know what I mean? Like, if this is what we're doing, then it's what we're doing.
Are you or not?
Yeah, it's like.
Are you down to die?
Yeah. Exactly.
Yeah, that's true. Loyalty is very rare in these days. So if you find that shit.
It's like, boom, I'm with it.
Keep that. Yeah. What do you like in bed specifically? Do you have any like little fetishes or like things girls can do? Like more
ease? Yeah, I was like aggressive.
Yeah.
I like.
Not afraid to take a jump.
Yeah,
you like to be submissive?
Nah, I like it to be like a fight.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? It's more passion, like
yeah, yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's the best kind. You're like, ooh, yeah.
And then after you do it, you like, I feel like you did something. You like,
it's like sweating.
Like, yeah, it's like in the deep tissue.
Yeah. That's good. What's one of the craziest sexual experiences that you've had?
Recently at a festival.
Oh, damn. Yeah. What festival?
It was in upstate New York.
Oh, damn.
That shit was fire. But because it was like in the middle of like nothing.
Yeah, you know, like in the forest and shit.
It was like, so that shit
it's
was
you so, two girls and nature.
Exactly.
Like how that intended it to be. Yeah.
It was, nightlife in the country and the fucking stars and shit. Like, the nature is the OG bed.
Yeah, right.
It's the OG bed.
Yeah.
It is.
And there's something to be said. Mother Nature, she supplies it.
She does.
Do you have any tips or advice for any kids who are going to be reading this, like sex advice or relationship advice?
Focus on you. In every aspect of it, you know what I'm saying? That's how you get better at sex, relationships, everything.
Yeah.
Focus on making yourself better. You know, be out searching for some shit, because you'll find it.
Yeah. It'll come to you, low key.
It won't.
Yeah.
So.
And also, you gotta be right to be in a relationship, you know? Like, you gotta be right in the head, like, in your heart and shit.
Yeah.
Like, if you're so. Work. How do you practice good communication?
Just make sure, like, I feel like a lot of people they distrust other people sometimes because they they aren't honest with themselves type shit, you know what I'm saying? So it's like, as long as you're honest with that person from the get-go, you don't have to hold nothing on your conscience or nothing. It's like,
for real. You know? Honesty is the best policy, I'll say it over and over again. What about when you're like on tour and stuff? How do you keep up with communication? Are you good at texting? Or like how? Because I know, I don't know, like I'm sure some people.
It depends.
Gotta be happening.
Yeah, it depends, you know. It's just like some days I feel like talking, some days I don't.
I know, same.
So I'm good at texting when you know I want to.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm like, I'm sorry, dude, I don't know you anything.
I'm not even trying to get it.
Yeah. Chill.